networked, green, intelligent, optical, all fiber. Today we're going to discuss at Huawei Connect here in Shanghai optical fiber networks which are green. Everybody knows this cables, the copper cables, but the copper is very expensive. It's hard to get out of the ground. And did you know that fiber is made of just sand? And sand is everywhere. So fiber is very cheap. And currently we have the fifth generation of fiber networks, which has a 200 gigabytes speed with bandwidth, which is tremendously fast, which I'm going to show you in just a minute. But it also has zero latency. And you have this all fiber networks. Now, let me show you by just playing a game. And I'm going to show you the Cat5, which is just 1000 MBS, the Cat5.E, which is 2.5 gigabits per second. And we have the fiber, which is 200 gigabits per second. And let me show you, if you start driving, how fast this is and how you can enjoy the speed from all green, intelligent, fiber optic networks. Let me show you how. Now let me show you the difference in speed. We start with the Cat5, which is 1000 MBS, 1 gigabyte. So I start driving here and it's rather slow, of course. Now let's switch to the Cat5E, which is 2.5 gigabits per second, which is already much faster. And now let's switch to 200 gigabits per second. And this is the speed that you want if you are either gaming or you're working at home or you're in the office. It doesn't matter. This speed is really giving you an experience that you cannot imagine if you're used to Cat or Cat5E. This is the speed that you want for the future. It's much cheaper, it's all green, and it's super fast for your best experience. Now, let's talk to Gavin Gu, and he's going to explain all the difference between the copper and the fiber and why everybody wants to move to fiber. But I think this shows exactly why. Let's go to Gavin. Hi, Gavin, how are you?
Nice to meet you, welcome.
Yeah,
welcome.
Yeah, thank you for having me. I just showed the first part with the speed for the all optical green intelligent networks, but now we're going to see the difference and why there's a difference between the copper and the fiber. Yes. Can you explain in more detail? I really want to know.
Yes. Welcome first. And we know that in operators, actually globally, all the operators in the past 10 years already replaced their copper with the fiber already. But in the campus network, most campus network is still built with the copper. And with the new service deployed, we see Wi-Fi 7 will be the next generation of the wireless network in the campus. And compared with the Wi-Fi 5 and the Wi-Fi 6, the Wi-Fi 7, the speed will go up to even more than 20 Gbps. That means the traditional cable cannot support so high speed. So the campus network should replace the copper with fiber. So this is the traditional copper network architecture. Mm-hmm. We see the last mile is 100 meters. With the Wi-Fi 7 use, you have to replace all these coppers. Why can't we directly choose the fiber to replace this copper? Yes, so fiber is a good idea. And Huawei here, we launched a new solution, FTTO fiber to the office. We use the PON technology with all this fiber. We see these two technology or two topology. So traditional is three-layer architecture, not FTTO, it's just two-layer. We use this passive splitter here to replace the aggregation layer and access layer. For the access, we use this small box, put this small box to the room. So the last mile of copper cable is just less than 10 meters compared to the old is 100 meters. So with the fiber deployed in the campus, actually, the fiber, it is like an infrastructure. Mm-hmm. You deploy the fiber, next 30 years, you didn't need to replace it anymore. It is long-term with the long evolution. And the FTTO 2.0, here we have some upgradation also.
And what does it mean for the deployment? Is it also faster to deploy?
Yes, first the faster deployment and the most important thing is that if you deploy it one time, you will don't need to replace it anymore. As I just mentioned, with the upgradation of the wireless network like Wi-Fi 4, Wi-Fi 5, Wi-Fi 6, Wi-Fi 7, each upgradation 5 years, you need to replace all your cables. But now with the fiber deployed one time, you don't need to replace it anymore. This is very important. You know, in the traditional network, each Ethernet is switch. It has IP. You need to configure some IP if some box has failure. But with FTTO solution, if this box has failures, anyone can just take one box here and give the power it. You can plug and play. Everything is, you know, configured in the remote, in the center, automatically.
And now the most important question is, what's the difference for the people that live on the campus? So what different type of experiences can they have? Can you describe what they can do with the existing solution? And if you move to fiber, what does it mean?
Yes, this is a good question. Let's go this way. Here we have different scenarios, like in education, in healthcare, hotel, and manufacture. We do some demo here. We can visit here.
Let's go there.
Okay.
So Gavin, we discussed the different scenarios and whether you are on a campus or in a hospital or in an office or in a hotel. It basically doesn't matter, of course, but can you explain what it means for the guest or for either the nurses or the people that stay in the hospital? What's the difference for them?
Okay, so actually we try to use this one board to show all the scenarios, because you know that in the real campus is very complex. We just show something, key information here. In the upper side, it is the smart classroom. It's about education. Actually, in the smart classroom, especially in China, a classroom must usually have more than 12 information points. If we use the traditional solution, you have a ELV room to deploy Ethernet access switch and use maybe 30 meters each information point.
Okay.
So it's very long. But with the fiber, we can here, we just put one fiber to this classroom, one fiber, to replace all the 12 30 meters cables. And we deploy one optics star P893E here. It can support all the information input in this room, just one fiber and one small box. And this box also supports 4x AP access. It means 4x 2.5G to access 4 AP and also support other information input in the classroom. Actually, it's very important the information or the feature here is that in the uplink, it supports the PON trunk. FTTO 2.0 upgraded the bandwidth from 10 Gbps to 12.5 Gbps. And the PON trunk means 2x 12.5 Gbps, 25G to the one classroom. So it's amazing speed.
And what does that mean for the students? What couldn't they do before and what can they do now? For example, can they use 8K type of videos? Can they do really detailed type of analysis on screen? Can they use VR? What is possible?
Actually, you already answered my questions. Actually, in the smart classrooms, all the things like the HD video, the education from maybe other schools to this classroom, yes, remote education. And also like the XR, this kind of XR, this kind of AR, this kind of remote education can be deployed in this kind of smart classroom. Yes, all these kind of intelligence applications.
And for the hospital, because in the hospital you see it over here, you have scans. Normally it was very hard to transfer these type of scans because these are very big files.
Yes.
What happens if they install fiber?
Okay, so actually in the hospital, this scenario, we have a very, very useful two applications. The first is what you said is the this kind of CT. We have this very, very small SIPOEO. We can put this one in the end of the or belong the machine. And this SIP module can support 10 Gbps. That means 10 Gbps to the machine, mm-hmm. to the CT machine. So mm-hmm. you can imagine you just need 1 second to get all the information of CT machine. This is one. Another is that actually a lot of hospitals have a mobile world round, this kind of service. Yes, And we also can provide this kind of new Wi-Fi 7 AP and also support almost zero failing of the roaming. Yes, if you go to the different world, you cannot feel the internet is switched to different AP. Roaming is zero like that.
Yeah, so for if you look to transferring these files, sometimes now it takes half a day. Yeah. And that means that the analysis from a patient takes sometimes another day, it needs to be sent back. Now it's just in
real time.
Yeah, almost real time. So it really means much faster analysis for the patients, and this means much better entertainment.
Yes.
Then traveling. I stay at many hotels.
Yes.
And I always like to be entertained and have all kinds of experiences in the hotel. So what's different if a hotel has optical fiber versus they have this Cat5 or Cat5e?
Okay, actually here, if we consider the hotel, actually every room, every hotel room, we usually have the internet, but we also have telephone. Previously, when you deploy this kind of network, you have a telephone where it is different compared to the Ethernet.
Mm-hmm.
But with Huawei FTTO solution, we can see we put one box in the room and it supports two types of where. One is the Ethernet. You can use it for the internet, yes. Also, it is AP, it is wireless. Another, it can provide one telephone. So with this box, you don't need to deploy different kind of cable to your room, just one fiber to your room. It's very, very beautiful, make the room very beautiful. Another thing is that this kind of box, it support a remote power with the fiber. That means actually if a hotel sometimes, if the power, the whole hotel power is not good, sometimes there is no electricity, then this kind of network still work.
So it's power over fiber?
Yes, power over fiber. Can use a different electricity system to keep this network.
And last year at MWC, I have seen also these fiber cables, which you just can stick to the wall. So you don't have to draw all these lines through all the pipes. You just can put it, this very thin line over the wall, which makes the deployment much easier, invisible basically. And you just can stick it on the wall, which was very easy.
Yes, this is very important. You know, fiber solution, actually all the people think fiber is very good, yes, no people doubt it, but sometimes deployment maybe have a little complex for customers or for some partners. What's your side? Just we use the transparent fiber to solve all this problem.
And the management part, so normally it takes quite some resources to manage. What's the difference for the resources to manage all the different APs?
Previously actually, if you deploy fiber, maybe we don't know what's the fiber architecture, but with this management system, we can see how the fiber deployed in the whole network. So make the fiber like from the black box to white box to you can manage the fiber first. Another thing is that with this kind of FTTO solution, because all the configuration is deployed in the ORTs, so if there is some failures of the box in the room, you just replace it. All the configuration of box, if you insert a new, and the new configuration will download from the ORTs automatically. So it's very easy to deploy this.
Is it AI driven?
Like AI driven, but it's not based on AI, but similar logic. Easy management. Yes.
Thanks, Kevin. I think it's a great improvement of the experience, but on the other hand, for the deployment, much easier. I'm going to watch an 8K VR type of experience. So thanks a lot.
Thank you. Thank
and
you very much.
For all the explanation, and let me go to the next one.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. We've seen fiber for the classroom, for the hospital, whether it's in the hotel, for the gaming. But it's not only for these places, of course, it's also for your office. And there's a small solution, the FTTO, the mini FTTO, the fiber to the office. And if you think that mini sounds small, but it's capable of a lot. So I have here an artist creating great pieces of art, and I'm going to watch it in virtual reality. In this case, it's 180 degrees in 8K. And for everybody who ever wears such a device, it is amazing to see how realistic it already is in 4K. But can you imagine doing this in 8K? It feels really like being there, and there's hardly anything to distinguish from reality. So I'm going to put it on. I'm going to describe it for you from what I'm seeing. So initially it's starting up, of course. I need to stay in my space over here. And now I can see that he's creating the art. But as I said, it really feels as if I am here. It is so bright, it is so clear. It is really an experience where you think, okay, why should I go somewhere? Why should I travel? Because the experience that 8K can bring is really the next level. And that's already possible with this mini FDTO. Now, what we have seen, whether you are gaming, whether you are in the hospital and need to send over the CT scans, whether you are in the office or in the classroom where you want to have next level type of experiences with VR and product presentations, or you are in a hotel and have great experiences. The next level of experiences is with fiber. And that's, it's cheaper, not on the other hand, it is a better experience. So it's basically, it's a no-brainer, but also for the deployment, it's much easier. Where, for example, in this case, you have five devices just in one device, which makes the deployment very easy and also easy to maintain. Thank you for watching to this booth tour here at Huawei Connect in Shanghai. It's an amazing show with all kinds of new developments, but this is one where you think, okay, this is really going to change my experience at home, in the office, and basically any place where you have fiber. Thanks a lot for watching, and we look forward to seeing you next time.